Steven Jackson. Only took one visit for him to figure out how radio people dress. Yeah. I mean, last time, a suit and a tie looking like you're going to dinner somewhere nice. And today, it's T-shirt and sweatpants and, mm-hmm. and
flippity flops.
And he's still the best dressed guy in the room.
Yeah, oh, he no. is.
So let's start.
I got a Southern shirt on and Gremlin pants.
Wow, causing, you sure do.
Causing conflict wherever you
Man.
Go.
Man.
Let's start with HB 667.
Okay.
First of all, what do you think about that?
I think it's good legislation. It's good public policy, and it's correcting an issue. It's going to correct an issue that we have here in the city of Shreveport.
For anybody that doesn't know, explain to and in your mind, what is the number one priority, the number one purpose of Representative Glover's bill?
Well, it is to fix the flaws in the bill. It is to make it compatible with the bills that are in New Orleans, the same redevelopment authority that's in New Orleans, the same redevelopment authority that's in East Baton Rouge Parish, the same mm-hmm. redevelopment authority that's in New Iberia, the same redevelopment authority.
But the purpose of the bill would be for Shreveport to what?
To take a lot of the blight and adjudicated properties and to help restore economic development within the inner core of the city of Shreveport, just as it's called for in chapters 11 and 12 of the 2030 master plan.
For someone to say that the city, maybe an idiot in the room said, should the city be in the real estate business?
What I said was, what the idiot said was, I think at the end of the day, should the city of Shreveport spend X amount, or should the taxpayers mm-hmm. spend X amount of dollars yet to be determined by people other than you, by the way?
Right. Well,
should the city be in the property flipping business?
Right. Well, it's not necessarily putting the city in the property flipping business. It is establishing a quasi-public body. And I've heard the folks say, well, these are non-elected officials. But I tell folks, look, you got a port. You have an airport authority, mm-hmm. you have an MPC, we have a library board, we have a Red River Waterway Commission. All of these are the same. We have a downtown development authority.
They all have the authority to call taxing elections.
To have an election and to own property. They have the authority to do redevelopment. And so...
Don't their elections, though, need the blessing of the city council?
The elections have to have the blessing of a local governing authority.
This one does not.
Yes, it would. It would require. And if it's not, you know, that can be amended into the bill. Let me go back and make a correction to what I just said. No, the port, when they did their election, they didn't have to call it by anybody. The port just called their election when Biomedical Research Foundation did their renewal.
But is that okay with you?
I mean, it's been fine with us for... The last, how long has Biomed been around?
The big issue for me is that it's a 5-member board. Mm-hmm. 3 of them are appointed by the mayor. Mm-hmm. We might have the most wonderful, upstanding, ethical mayor
Correct.
Of all time.
Correct.
And I'm not pointing any fingers at anybody in particular. What if one day we have a corrupt mayor?
Well, that's why you have advise and consent.
Or even...
What do you mean, advise and consent?
Well, they're appointed by the mayor but confirmed by the city council. So it's not the mayor making a unilateral decision.
But they rubber stamp those. You know that.
Well now the onus is back on your city councilman to not rubber stamp whatever that particular mayor is doing. So you have advise and consent. So it's not the mayor making a unilateral appointment. They go through a vetting process and they go on. That's how the Downtown Development Authority is appointed. That's how the Tourist Board is appointed. That's how the MPC is appointed. The mayor makes the appointment. The council ratifies and approves it. That's the system of government we have at the local, state, and federal level.
Why is it that the state of Louisiana feels compelled or has the power mm-hmm. to make all these rules for the city of Shreveport? I mean, what if the city of Shreveport doesn't want that?
Well, as I understand it, and let me go back, because I listened to the show yesterday and heard Representative Seabaugh say that this was something that just kind of came out of nowhere. That is completely false. That is a lie.
Mm-hmm.
And I took offense to that, because in 2015, I worked with Mayor Tyler. And we sat down and we talked to Representative Carmody, we talked to Representative Seabaugh, we talked to Senator Peacock and Tarver. We talked to all of our delegation.
What did Seabaugh say that most offended you?
He said that, you know, the bill came up in 2015. He had never seen it. He had never saw it. And he had never heard of it. And just before it came up on the House floor, Carmody pulled him. That is not true. We had a legislative luncheon with those guys at the Petroleum Club. We gave them a legislative sheet that was endorsed and signed off by the city council.
But that was the 9-member board originally. This correct. New 5-member board.
No. That bill was amended.
Right.
So the makeup of the board that you see right now was not the original makeup of the board. We went back and forth and amended that board, and I have the documents.
But I guess just to split hairs, is the bill, is the board, the redevelopment authority that CBAW is talking about, correct. Is that the 9-member as opposed to the 5-member that the Senate is going to be considering?
I believe the actual original bill was 7 members, because I actually sat down and wrote this bill, gave it to... what happens is a member sponsors it, or they get it to the Legislative Bureau and they sponsor it. But as far as from a local level, I was in day one with the crafting of the language of the bill. And it was actually originally a 7-member.
Hang on there, kid. Can we go to break? Then we'll come back. We got lots more questions. Sure.